What's going on, baby? Slickcock is here. Thank you so much for stopping by. And today, we are going to be discussing the fact that a gun that's not even in the game yet made the Destiny 2 community furious. And so, let's get started. But just before we do, a huge amount of people who watch this channel aren't yet subscribed. Take a quick second to hit that subscribe button and that bell to be notified of future content, and you can always unsubscribe later. All right, now what the heck am I talking about? Because that claim seems kind of outlandish. A gun that isn't even in the game has made people very, very mad. But that is not an exaggeration whatsoever. Now, here's the story. A few TWABs ago, which is the weekly update Bungie put out, they announced that they're bringing back a much-loved feature, which is ritual slash pinnacle slash pursuit weapons. Kind of sounds complicated, but in the beginning there was pinnacle weapons. These were things that came out every season. There was one for the Crucible, eventually there was one for Strikes, and one for Gambit, and you could do a lengthy quest to acquire these more powerful than normal weapons. And although they warped the meta, certainly, people generally liked going after these weapons. Now, to kind of calm down that power potential and to stop them from warping the meta, Bungie introduced ritual weapons. These were much more toned down. There was still a lengthy quest to go and acquire them, but they didn't have any unique perks, rather just a set of perks that usually guns didn't have and were just generally decently powerful, but not meta warping per se. But then even those went away, and we've had several seasons where that whole concept of, you know, these legendary weapons that you would acquire after going through a lengthy quest, that disappeared until it was announced that it is coming back in the form of one pursuit weapon. Essentially, there's one big lengthy quest, not three weapons tied to the three main activities, but rather one weapon, and the quest lets you play either Strikes or Crucible or Gambit, play your way to acquire this one weapon. And that one weapon was the adorned sniper rifle. Here is a picture of it. Not only would you acquire this weapon and then have a semi-unique weapon, there's still some debate and question as to whether this weapon will have unique, unusual perks or just similar perks set up in a way to make it kind of an automatic god roll. That remains to be seen when Beyond Light launches. But this weapon is also accompanied by three different ornaments. And after you earn it, you can go on additional quests to unlock an ornament for the Crucible, and then an ornament for Gambit, and lastly an ornament for Strikes. So, hey, you love Strikes, then you can not only get this weapon through playing Strikes, you can then keep playing Strikes and get the ornament to show people how much you love Strikes. But of course, the question is, where does the outrage come from? Because all of that is actually pretty good news, as, like I said, right now we currently don't have any form of pursuit weapon. Well, it comes from this picture, just this picture, because this weapon is actually an obvious reskin of an existing Destiny 2 legendary weapon. Underneath the tarp, very clearly, as you can see, it's the beloved legendary sniper rifle. Now, the beloved or the beloved, this thing is cracked. Like, this is one of the most used PvP weapons in the entire game, capable of getting some astoundingly good god rolls, especially quick draw plus snapshot. Like, the beloved came out over a year ago and is still a mainstay in the meta. So, people got upset. They really did, as you can see. And also, this was memed on. People photoshopped the same tarp over existing pinnacle weapons saying, oh lol, is this what Bungie's gonna do for pursuit weapons going forward? Is just drape a tarp over existing weapons? People were not happy due to the fact that this was a kind of a clearly obvious reskin. People were saying, you finally bring back pinnacle weapons in the form of pursuit weapons, and you're too lazy to design a new weapon, Bungie? Like, you really have to just have an existing weapon and literally just throw a tarp over it? In fact, people were so upset, they were upset at me for not being as upset as them. In fact, in that same day, I got called a hater because I said that everyone uses the support supers in PvE because why would you use Sunbreakers when an entire Hammer's super can't even take out a champion? And then I got called a fanboy for not calling out the reskins. Yeah, I just can't win. But again, do they have a point? Well, they certainly do about it being a reskin. There is absolutely no debate. It is clearly an already existing weapon with a little tarp thrown over it. It is 100%, you know, mostly a reskin of a weapon. But one of the reasons I didn't care about this as much as other people is I viewed it as an homage. I viewed it as Bungie doing this on purpose, kind of knowing that the Beloved is going to be sunsetting when Beyond Light hits. You'll still be able to use it in PvP where it's still very highly used, but not in the Light Matters PvP playlists like Iron Banner, for example. So Bungie's kind of saying, hey, potentially we're bringing back a snipe rifle, a very good PvP snipe rifle. Maybe it can get that same Beloved role of a quick draw plus snapshot sights, and they're kind of hinting at that being a possibility. And so it's very possible that what Bungie thought was a cool nod to the community and people would be happy about went horribly, horribly wrong, and now people are very upset about them reskinning it. I also think a lot of the anger comes from people who are not happy about sunsetting, and to them, this what may have been a good-natured homage, apparently, looks more like an insult almost, because they're saying, hey, remember that gun that you kind of should be able to use, but now you can't because we arbitrarily introduced sunsetting? Well, here it is again, lol, right? And it kind of is insulting to them because they're thinking, well, we should just be able to use the dang Beloved. Now we have a reskin Beloved. Like, Bungie's basically making fun of the fact that we're all losing our best weapons, and they're just kind of reintroducing them with a tarp over them. I think that was a big part of it. Because Destiny 2 has always had its fair share of reskins. I mean, a huge portion of exotic weapons and armor come directly from Destiny 1. And that, I think, is Bungie trying to create one game. Like, Destiny 1 will eventually die out. Destiny 2, I think, is what Bungie is trying to create as the definitive Destiny experience. And to people who didn't play Destiny 1, these exotics are totally new. And then you have, I mean, this picture here. This is a set of weapons coming with Beyond Light, and they are the furthest thing from reskins. These are extremely unique designs. Heck, Bungie showed off the bottom one here during a live stream, and it was so different and so unique, the entire community had a debate over what this gun was. Now, I personally think it's a shotgun, but still, like, most people couldn't even recognize what the heck this gun is. So the same company you're accusing of being reskin central and lazy are at the same exact time making extremely unique weapon designs. And I think at the end of the day, the fact of the matter is that there's truth to all of it. Like, it does make sense that people would see this kind of, again, if you're anti-sunsetting, get upset by it and call it out for being lazy. I do really think it was more of an homage, but also probably a little bit of a concession on Bungie's part, because the Destiny community has an insatiable need for content, right? And Bungie's trying to add as many guns as they possibly can to each expansion and each season, and often they're very unique designs. Like, the Warmind weapons look very unique. The Season of Dawn weapons look very unique. Bungie has been excellent at introducing these themed weapons that all look unique. So they introduce one weapon that's a bit of a reskin, and I think people kind of went a bit overboard. Especially because, in my opinion, what matters most is gameplay. I'll take reskinned weapons all day long if they have unique and different perks and perk layouts and perk combinations. Like, I am always interested when we get a weapon that can get a combination of perks that we haven't seen before, or a weapon that exists within an archetype that it doesn't usually, or a perk that goes on a weapon of an archetype that usually doesn't get that perk, or of course, a brand new perk which this adorned weapon might just have. That, to me, makes the actual experience of playing the game different and unique, and is much more important than making a gun look unique, but then that gun has Feeding Frenzy kill clip for the 1,000,000th time. The true sin, however, is if Bungie does both. If it's a reskin weapon that also doesn't have any unique perks, I think that is a little bit lazy. And unfortunately, we're getting a lot of that in the current season with a lot of the weapons, gnawing hunger, etc., being brought up and getting new versions of that that aren't actually new versions. They're the exact same weapon with the exact same role, but they're being brought forward to avoid problems with not having enough weapon diversity when sunsetting hits with Beyond Light. So it's very understandable at the end of the day why people are jaded, and I think Bungie needs to take this into consideration. You're not going to be able to get away with as many reskins until sunsetting has kind of set in and you've introduced a lot more new stuff, then people are going to be more tolerant of it. But that's the overview of the occurrence, the latest thing within the Destiny community to make people upset. Guys, if you enjoyed the video, please remember to support it by liking and especially sharing. If you want to see more Destiny 2 content similar to this, be sure to subscribe. If you want to get in touch with me and keep up to date with the latest channel activity, the best way is to follow me on Twitter at @RickKakis. That's linked in the description down below. Again, I hope you enjoyed the video, and as always, have a good day.